People love titles. The world of convention does not sit well with mediocrity and genericism. We glory in achievements, in trophies, medals, and official citations of merits, and outstanding contributions of whatever kind. Small wonder individuals the world over try with might and main to be known as unique, great, even heroic, definitely a cut above the rest. An old movie on Mozart entitled Amadeus presents this earthly and worldly tendency of each one of us so well in the person of the envious and devious character of Salieri, who was portrayed as consumed with jealousy over that rambunctious, rambling, and awkward upstart name Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, then the rising star favored by the powers that be. In his final years, a more mellowed Salieri took to recounting his sad story of acknowledged guilt and remorse over a lifetime wasted by so much envy. He declared himself in his memoirs as the patron saint of mediocrity. Even as he acknowledged the undeniable brilliance and genius of the man whose achievements he so lusted after and coveted all his life, he craved for fame. He groveled after accomplishment. He pined for glory and the acclaim of people. If I remember that old movie well, Salieri did not get anywhere near getting what he longed for and was so green with envy for. He gloried in the wrong stuff, hitched his dream to the wrong wagon. His heart, like the hearts of all of us in our unenlightened and unredeemed moments, was filled with lights contrary to God's own. Today our prayer hits home and hits hard in the hearts and minds of all pusillanimous and selfish people. We ask God as Father, let the light of your truth guide us to your kingdom through a world filled with lights contrary to your own. Christian is the name in the gospel we glory in. May your love make us what you have called us to be. Lights contrary to God's own. Isn't this representative of the times we live in? Isn't this the situation of a world filled with deeply contrasting tones of sinfulness and grace-filledness? Aren't we living in a world immersed in a reality which the classical Dickensian terms refer to as the best of times and the worst of times? God's lights inundate our world. We live in the best of time. We live in God's time, and we are all awash in God's fruitfulness. Scripture says, "Shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it." God's lights flood our world. Despite all the problems the world is facing, in spite of all the worries we as a people are now facing, on all fronts, we stand witness to the truth of what we proclaim today. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. God's lights fill our world in our hearts. Faith gives us perspective and makes us see things for what they are, compared to what is in store for all of us. Consider that the suffering of this world are nothing compared to what? To the glory to be revealed for us. Today's liturgy would not have us dwell on dirges. On the contrary, it makes us rise in celebration of hope, even if we see lights contrary to God's own around us. Life is full of hope. Lights contrary to God's own may surround us, but God's hope pervades us, and it calls us to further hope and trust. God bless you all.